I, 26M, am straight, but I think I have feelings for my friend, 24M, and I'm super confused. Okay, please bear with me as I'm pretty confused about the whole thing. I've been friends with A since uni. We hit it off quickly and became close. I consider him one of my best friends. A is bisexual, and never kept it a secret, not that it ever bothered me. A week ago we all went out to the pub, now that things are opening up. It was great fun, even if some of us had a few too many. Although we FaceTimed almost every day, this was one of the first times me and I have seen each other in person, so it's still exciting. A is a lightweight, so when it was time for us to leave, I basically had to drag him out. He said I was his knight in shining armor, and wouldn't stop giggling. When we got into the cab, we tumbled in and sort of fell on each other. We laughed, and he looked up at me, smiling, and for a second, I suddenly had the urge to kiss him. I don't know why. I've never felt that way before. And never about a guy. It freaked me out, so I immediately sat up and tried to shake it off. I dropped him off and made sure he got in safely before going home and barely sleeping. I figured it was just a drunken moment, and that I was lonely because of lockdown. But I couldn't stop thinking about it. A few days ago, we were watching a horror movie, which he doesn't love but is willing to suffer for me lol. Almost every time there was a jump scare, he clutched onto me. At one point there was a particularly gory scene and he buried his head in my shoulder and said to tell him when it's over. This is normal, we've always been pretty tactile with each other. But now I'm confused. I realized I like it. I like being close to him, and I like that he wants to be close to me, too. It sounds stupid but I can't stop analyzing it. And since the pub, once or twice he's looked at me and I thought about kissing him again. It's driving me crazy. I keep going over everything, and I can't figure out if I'm just confused or if I really do have feelings for him. I couldn't avoid him even if I tried. I'd miss him too much, but now, being around him is stressful, because I can't stop the whirlwind of thoughts and confusion. He knows there's something wrong, but I just told him work stress has triggered a bout of insomnia, which has happened before. I'm scared, to be honest. I've never had feelings for a guy, at least I don't think I have, and it feels late to discover this about myself. I love him to bits and I don't want to ruin our friendship all because I'm confused. And it sucks because the one person I would normally talk to about this is the person who's directly involved. Does anyone have any advice on how I should handle this? I don't want to ruin our friendship, but I can't get him or these feelings out of my head. Straight 24YO male here, and I just have to say this all sounds pretty darn cute. Maybe just have an open discussion about it? If you are so close, A should understand if you ultimately realize you are not into it and go back to being straight. It's never too late to discover things about yourself. Life is about constantly evolving and growing into the people we're meant to be. Communication is key, and if these feelings are keeping you up at night, I feel the best thing to do would be to talk to A about where you're at and how you're feeling. Just be completely open and honest about everything on your mind. Love is love, and you never know. He could end up being your soulmate and things could flourish even more than they already have. I wish you the best of luck in the future and I hope everything works out in your favor. Do what makes you happy, smile. Some people only realize they aren't straight in their 40s and beyond, so don't be thinking it's too late to learn new things about yourself. Maybe instead of trying to figure out what label might fit you, because not all of us fit only one label, beyond, maybe not entirely straight, and focus on the feelings themselves. Do you think you would want to do sexual things with this friend, or is it more wanting to just be close to him in a cuddly way, or both? Once you've processed those feelings a bit and have an idea of whether you want to try for more or try to keep things just friends, talk to him. He's bi, so even if he doesn't reciprocate your feelings, he has probably felt similarly in the past and could help you figure things out. It's fine to admit to yourself that you're not straight. Yeah, you're not straight, my dude. Good for you. Good luck. Ohms, this is significant other cute. It's okay. It is literally never too late to discover yourself. Honestly, just tell him. I'm rooting for you. I know this might sound extremely unhelpful, but you actually should be talking to him about this. Because you will both be able to work out how best to save your friendship if you realize you didn't have romantic feelings. He might not even be romantically into you either but enjoys the closeness. Or he's giving you the space to realize yourself because he does. Just know that sexuality is never one over the other. You could lean most towards women sexually, romantically, but still have room for the right person to slip in regardless of gender. That is something only you can know about yourself and what you have to think most about. Indulge your maybe feelings for a minute. Can you picture intimate moments or an entire future with him? Hey, I'm pansexual and non-binary, so here's some advice. A sexual awakening is never too early or too late. I knew I was gay at 9 and 4 years later I still am. If you really want to figure this out, accept yourself first. If you keep pretending this never happened, you'll never know. Signs point to you are in fact part of the community, but there is a huge chance you're straight. You know, not us. If you do like him, don't worry, you don't need to put a label on your sexuality. If you don't, then that's completely okay. False alarm YK? Stay safe. I changed boundaries in my marriage, but he didn't listen and now I'm hurt and confused. So me and my husband have been practicing poly for the last year almost. And we have always had this non-consensual consented sex play. So when I fall asleep, he would do things to me and I would wake up and we would progress to the full thing. Over the last couple of years, I've not enjoyed it as much, so I've told him not to do it past a certain time because I cannot wake for work properly or it makes me stay awake all night once I'm woken. So yeah, I said please don't do it so late to begin with. I asked my husband recently if it was okay that we don't do it anymore because it feels odd for me and I don't feel comfortable with it anymore. But he didn't think this was fair due to a few reasons. I changed it on the spot to, can you make sure I'm awake then 1000% awake? Because recently I've slept through it and that made me uncomfortable too. So he agreed and said fine, he will make sure I'm awake before he has sex with me but will still instigate whilst I'm asleep. So fast forward to last night, 3-4 a.m. Now I have an infection down there at the moment from antibiotics. He knows this, I've not stopped complaining about this. But anyway, I was asleep when I woke up to confusing pleasure but with a lot of pain. I pretended to stay asleep because I was so shocked he had made this move during a time where I'm experiencing a lot of pain and discomfort and at the time he chose. He then proceeded to try and wake me up, so I woke and batted him away and said no. Pretending to be semi-asleep, so he tried to enthusiastically wake me again. I looked up at him and he said, you were wet and backing into me, I think you need to clean yourself up. Which made me sick to my core because I know full well I didn't back into him and I was fully dressed before. I got into bed and pretended to go back to sleep whilst he pleasured himself and didn't say anything else to me. I just don't know how to feel about it, but I do feel violated. I don't know what to do because other than this he is incredibly wonderful. But is that still not justifying his actions? I have no idea what to do. You are being assaulted while you are asleep. Please seek some therapy. Your husband is betraying your trust. He is not abiding by your wishes to sleep so you can work, etc. His behavior is abhorrent. You have a very frank and truthful conversation with him. And I think you probably need to consider closing the relationship back down until you get your primary relationship back on track. Trust is the most important thing in any relationship and I understand particularly in poly relationships. So get that back in place before you do anything else. Pretending your husband isn't sexually assaulting you, because that is what we call it when someone does sexual acts on us without our consent or in this case despite a clear no by pretending to be asleep, is not okay. Not for either of you. Op, it kinda sounds to me like you were sexually assaulted. To me this whole thing just seems messy and confusing. With this poly stuff, with you being in a lot of pain and pretending to sleep, and completely ignoring him trying to wake you up. Yeah, he's crossing boundaries into sexual assault, but I'm curious, if you are having issues like this, you think continuing another relationship with someone else is going to be okay? I'm also curious if he decides to change his boundaries as well and shut down the poly play, would you oblige him? Just wanna add, he's woken up, I haven't slept, and he's just going about his morning as usual. I thought poly meant there was a third person involved? Anyway, he sounds selfish and inconsiderate. Kick him out. Your husband definitely doesn't respect your boundaries. Update. I, 28F, fought my fiancé, 24 male, while blackout drunk. Original post. It's been about 2 months since my post. I'm still sober and in a relationship. My fiancé and I had a long conversation and agreed I needed to go to therapy and stop drinking. All I can say is that I am one lucky woman to have a man so forgiving and understanding. I have absolutely learned my lesson and realize I had a lot of hidden issues I never wanted to address and would use alcohol to help bury that feeling. Although I don't necessarily have a drinking problem, I have enjoyed the benefits of being sober and think it's best not to drink until I figure myself out. I still feel like a bad person, and although my fiancé has forgiven me, I haven't forgiven myself. I'm glad I started therapy. Even those free therapy AI apps have been a great thing for me when I needed help in that instant. I would absolutely recommend it for anyone in a similar situation. Edit. I love that despite already being in therapy and being proactive about getting help, most people think I'm lying and will revert to being an alcoholic loser like their own family members. Fuck you guys that think that because you don't even know me, and I use haters like you guys as fuel to prove I'm better than what you think of me. I know what I have to lose, unlike whatever the fuck happened to your alcoholic family members. Also, I didn't fucking groom anyone. We had 6 other people in our friend group growing up, and I was in relationships until after he turned 18. I'm not a fucking pedo. For those few with encouraging words or tough advice, thank you. I know I made a huge mistake and am making sure my fiancé won't regret giving me another chance. I'm motivated and dedicated to being the woman he deserves. Stay away from alcohol, don't even go back to it even when you've decided you've figured yourself out, and keep going to therapy. Little concern to see, I'll never touch alcohol again, turn into. Think it's best not to drink until I figure myself. You allude on your first post to having parents with a drinking problem? If so, you should know how this climb down sounds. This post reminds of my alcoholic mom. Crocodile tears to hide their true lack of remorse. You have a drinking problem. Get help or you will be a 55-year-old 2x divorcee with a bottle of Chardonnay for company. I'm more than a bit concerned you think you don't have a drinking problem and that you'll go back to alcohol one day. Your fiancé and your mental health should be more important than ever considering going back to alcohol when you've proven you have an enormous problem with drinking to the point you blackout assaulted your boyfriend, and he's forgiven you once. R. Stop drinking. Why is everyone ignoring the fact you groomed a 14-year-old boy, waited until he turned 18, then gets drunk and abuses him? Dot. WTF people. Girl, no. You very much have an alcohol drinking problem. You're an alcoholic. With this mindset, you'll be back blackout drunk within a couple of months. You need to realize that you have a problem. You need therapy. You need special help for your alcohol problem. Don't touch a drink, cause you'll just end up falling back into old habits. The fact that you don't even admit to yourself that you have a problem is the biggest indicator that you haven't improved as much as you'd like to think. Ah, the old classic, I don't technically have a drinking problem. Sure you don't, winking face. First of all, he was 18 and you 22. Then you beat him up and he forgave you. Sorry, but you sound like a fucking creep, poor guy. If the genders were reversed. My husband is experiencing morning sickness and I hate it. I am not sure if this is where I'm supposed to post this, so sorry if it's not. My husband, 28M, and I, 29F, have been arguing over this issue. I'm now 11 weeks pregnant with my first baby and I've been experiencing morning sickness and it's been horrible, like constantly throwing up. A while after I first started experiencing morning sickness, my husband has also started to experience something similar. I was told that sometimes husbands can also experience this and it's called sympathetic pregnancy. The thing is, I hate it. I hate that he's going through it, and for some reason it really annoys me. And it's not just like a small feeling of annoyance, but more of an utterly disgusted feeling. I know that it's not something he can control, but I just get so pissed off when I see him get morning sickness. I feel like he'll never know what I'm going through, the constant discomfort and pain. It feels as if he's just mimicking me, like he'll never truly understand how hard this pregnancy is. This is my first time being pregnant, so I'm not sure if this is normal. I know it's wrong of me to think this, but I just can't stop, it seems so stupid. I told him about this and at first he wasn't sure what to say or do. We talked about it again and he said it wasn't anything he could do about it because he couldn't control it. And I get that, but I was kind of hoping he would stop doing it in front of me. I know this sounds stupid, but we keep arguing over it. I'm so torn because I know there's nothing he can do, but I just feel so frustrated and it's really affecting how I act around him. Because now I don't like having him around me. I was hoping to get some advice on this because no matter what I do, I can't shake off what I'm feeling. Should I go get therapy or is there anything I can do to stop feeling this way? 1. How does it affect you, really? How is it harming you? 2. He can't control it. It's an asshole move to be pissed off at someone who is experiencing physical issues that can't control it. Imagine if he got pissed at you for having morning sickness, or being crabby because you were premenstrual. 3. I would for sure suggest therapy. You have irrational anger towards him, for doing nothing that is acutely harming you. I think if you're able to, you should talk to a therapist. Because Cuvade syndrome can last the entire length of your pregnancy. And while understandable, you can't stay pissed off at him that long. When I was pregnant, my husband had so many pregnancy symptoms. He had nausea, gained weight, had insomnia, and, weirdly, had sore nipples at one point. I remember it being really annoying in my first trimester, with both my pregnancies, but then as the pregnancy progressed and I didn't feel so awful anymore, I thought it was kind of sweet. I don't think he'd be experiencing this if he wasn't a very sympathetic partner. The first trimester is awful, but it's fortunately almost over. See how you feel in a couple of weeks. But I was kind of hoping he would stop doing it in front of me. I feel sorry for your husband. You don't sound like a very nice person. I just had a baby and I get it. I think hormones are playing a part, and also I think you should talk to someone about it, especially if you have any other anxiety or depression symptoms. Because if you're being triggered by him being sick now, you're going to really resent when he doesn't go through labor and doesn't have to wake up as much at night and his life doesn't change as much as yours. I remember after 36 hours of labor, tearing, bleeding 2L, and preeclampsia, my husband, who had slept in the hospital, said he was tired and I almost lost my mind. But he was tired. We can both be tired. You're mad at him for something he can't control. Maybe you feel he's trying to take the attention away from you? But at the same time, it's his excitement too. I personally don't know anyone who has experienced sympathy sickness to the point of throwing up, but I know when my missus was pregnant with our second, I had sympathy pains myself, so it's definitely real. You're both about to raise a child together, things like this shouldn't bother you, emo. Maybe a therapist isn't a bad idea if you are really bothered by it, but you are both a team and should hold each other's hair over the dunny. Yeah, you need professional help. You are complaining how your husband will never feel the same amount of pain as you do, but then go along and minimize his pain and sickness. You are literally mad at him for being sick. Imagine how you would feel if he told you, "I don't mind that you are puking all the time, but just don't do it in front of me." Yeah, feels awful, doesn't it? Well, that's how you make him feel. It's probably hormones, but still, that doesn't make you less of an asshole for this behavior. Sure, you can feel that way, but the moment you act on THSOE feelings, that's when you become an asshole. How in the heck are you arguing with him about it? He can't control it. That's like if he told you to stop throwing up. Hello? You're coming off as very unreasonable. You need therapy because this is not okay.